Hunter, Morph Regus. I'm calling to recruit you for a special project. It's called Operation Dark Ice. It'll be the most dangerous thing you've ever done, but it could very well win the war. You're the best hunter in the galaxy. Can we count on your services?
I don't do volunteer work.
You'll be well paid, and you'll receive a temporary battlefield commission. It'll be your operation if you accept. I'm sending the coordinates for the planet Ilum. It used to be a frozen wasteland only a few Jedi bothered with. But a few weeks ago, Imperial scientists discovered a way to turn Adigan lightsaber crystals into the most significant breakthrough in military technology since the hyperdrive.
The hyperdrive revolutionized galactic warfare. Nothing before or since has matched it in importance.
I'm not exaggerating. Ilum has the biggest supply of Adigan lightsaber crystals in the galaxy, and our scientists have been most successful with Ilum's crystals. The Empire won on Corellia, but it was costly. We're outnumbered. We need the technological edge. We need Ilum's crystals. But as usual, the Republic's intent on interfering.
So you need me to crack some skulls while you handle the boring stuff?
You could say that. Ilum's a nasty place. Cold as Hoth, covered in ice and mountainous terrain. Makes moving large armies impossible. I hope to see you soon.
I see three flaws, Major. You've split your forces, you're vulnerable in the air, and you take our enemy for idiots. You think that Jedi isn't expecting this? Out!
Yes, sir.
Hunter, I hope we have a deal. I have your battlefield commission ready.
My payment, too?
When the job's done, Adigan crystals. Imperial scientists can now transform these glitzy bits of rock into the most powerful stealth technology in the galaxy. We want every ship in the Imperial Armada fitted with this tech. An unstoppable stealth armada.
I take it you've run into trouble, or you wouldn't have called me.
To succeed, we need two things. To control Ilum's crystal supply, and to bring our fleet safely to Ilum for modification. Ilum's no place for a war. Narrow passages, sharp jutting rocks, and the coldest wind you ever felt. But that Republic Admiral wants a war. He sent Jedi Master Jerik Kaden to lead the Republic's elite alien armies on the ground. Kaden's pinned us in.
The only reason Master Kaden is still around is because he hasn't met me.
I'm counting on that. The Jedi think of Ilum as their planet. Only two of them were here when we arrived, but they have ruins scattered around the place. The ruins housing Master Kaden's base are too small for anything but a strike team, and they're surrounded by cliffs full of Duras shock troopers.
You don't expect me to go on a suicide mission without a strategy.
Our only chance is to lure the Duras shock troopers into the open, where they're vulnerable. I've established fake supply depots between here and the ruins. Master Kaden is over-aggressive. He's already mobilized the shock troopers to capture the depots, clean out the Duros at the supply depots, and then assault the ruins' base.
Is there trouble, Master Kaden?
No, Admiral. My guests have simply arrived sooner than expected. Rest assured, this war can only end one way.
I was hired to kill you, that's all.
You just do your job. But do you ever stop to question what that job means? You are on Jedi land, and I'm only gonna ask once for you to leave.
If you're done talking, I'd like to do what I was paid to do.
Surely even a bounty hunter understands sacred things. The job, the hunt.
The crystals your Empire hopes to turn into a weapon of mass murder are visible signs of an invisible truth. The Force. A Jedi does not kill until forced. I would sooner kill every Imperial on Ilum than allow these crystals to be desecrated.
Then you'll die for something you believe in.
one with the Force, I will be even stronger.
Troopers, join me for the Republic!
This is a military matter, Malgus.
You appeal to the Dark Council for help. Here I am.
Master Caden is dead.
See, Malgus, we have everything under control.
Members of the Dark Council are not convinced. Darth Malgus, I'll just be observing for the time being.
Observing, hmm? Before his death, Master Caden ordered an army of Kalish mercenaries to take our only functioning crystal mine. We need the crystals. We need that mine. I want the Republic's Kalish army destroyed. Show the galaxy the price of allying with the Republic.
I'm going to need a really big bomb. Can't take down an entire army by hand.
It's a point. Your plan hardly seems efficient. The victory on Corellia cost us nearly a tenth of our forces. That's hardly a rate of attrition we can support, is it?
Does this have something to do with the mission, Malgus?
The Kalish are warlike, ritualistic people. In my brief time on Kali, I observed the ritual by which they chose their war leader. Challenge their general. Win their respect, and they will defend that mine to the death. For the Empire.
Aliens! You want us to recruit aliens?
It sounds like we could use some allies.
I'm in charge of this operation, not Malgus. The mine is at the end of a crystal cave, with several Republic outposts guarding it. Sure, challenge the Kalish general, then bring me his head.
Darth Malgus's plan makes more sense.
I will not trust the Empire to mercenary freaks.
If we don't bolster our forces, there will be no future for the Empire. Go to the mine, gather the weapons of the Kalish warriors, and plant them in the ice to initiate the rite of challenge.
I am War Leader Gilrix. Who challenges me?
The toughest fighter you ever met.
What do you want with the people of Kali?
The Empire wants you to join them and fight for them.
You have defeated my warriors. You are strong. You have issued the challenge. You are knowledgeable. But the Republic pays us well and offers us a place among their people.
The Empire are better warriors than the Republic will ever be.
If it's so, then prove it. The challenge must be honored. I bow to you, War Leader of the Kalish. This army is the Empire's to command.
Are you deliberately trying to provoke me?
I'm doing what I was sent to do. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have other matters to attend to.
And you? I did not request your help so that you could bring aliens into the Empire.
Then maybe I should leave you to do your own dirty work.
No, that's not necessary. The mine's been reclaimed. We can resume our crystal operations. Our best recon teams are scouting the Republic base for an attack. But in the meantime, we need to prepare for the arrival of the prototype fleet.
What's the reason for bringing the fleet to Ilum? Can't the stealth technology be transported?
We need the fleet in place on the surface. Everything we need to build the stealth armada is on that fleet. But the Republic's anti-aircraft artillery installation controls the skies. Anything that flies too low gets shot down. The Republic's artillery base is protected by a ray shield and the Republic's best alien forces. Delta Squad will disable the ray shield while you storm the base and destroy the guns.
Why can't Delta Squad storm the base?
We want to time the attack so you can strike the instant the ray shield goes down before the Republic can scramble reinforcements. Get into position at the comm relay just outside the artillery base. Contact Delta Squad when you're ready, and they'll bring the ray shield down. After that, it's up to you. Destroy those guns and get out of there. Alive.
Ambush! It was a trap. The Republic were waiting for us at the shield generators. We're under heavy fire. I don't know how long we can...
Did you hear that? Somebody's played us for fools. The Republic artillery base is protected by a huge ray shield. We can't destroy the anti-air guns until that ray shield is down. Looks like you have a new mission. Destroy the shield generators, and then attack the Republic artillery base and take out the guns.
Guess I gotta clean up your mess again.
Just make the explosions nice and loud. Remember, you won't be able to reach the Republic's artillery until the ray shield is down. Take out the shield generators, and then destroy the guns. Contact me at the Republic base once both the shield generators and the guns are destroyed. My men will move in and clean up.
The guns are destroyed.
We're slicing the Republic's computers now. Let's see what they're doing out there in the cold.
Ah, Master Caden's killer. He was a good man, and will be sorely missed. But killing one great man is never enough. The Republic has always thrived on the effort of its united citizens. Lieutenant, input the coordinates of the Imperial base into the ELX-25 and fire when ready. Give my regards to Moff Regis.
Blast! The ELX-25 was only supposed to be in planning stages. If it's operational, it could obliterate our base with a single shot.
Then we'd better work quickly. Get me the coordinates and I'll destroy it.
We're tracing the Admiral's signal now. We have to improvise. Based on estimates of the ELX-25's range and the origin of the Admiral's transmission, it should be at these coordinates. We have limited time, and you're closest. Destroy that weapon.
Sometimes you need to adapt to survive.
Destroy the ELX-25, or we'll have no choice but to retreat from Ilum.
How did the Republic learn of our plans?
All the more reason the Empire needs to reimagine itself for the changing times.
Once we build a stealth armada, we won't need change.
Stow the philosophy. You hired me to fight a war.
Perhaps we should move on. Our conversation is not stimulating enough for the Hunter.
The Republic's base is built into a cliffside. The main fleet is going to batter the exposed side to oblivion. The objective is to claim the Republic crystal supplies, kill Admiral Shai, and open the docking bay door so Imperial forces can clean up. You'll be entering through this tunnel and hitting deep within the mountain, where the fleet can't reach.
And while you and the main fleet give the Republic a beating, I'll prep the crystal fleet for the transfer of the Republic's crystals.
A two-pronged attack. Are you on board?
I came to Ilum to win this war. I'm not going to quit now.
If you're ready, Darth Malgus.
The Dark Council has placed me at your command.
Then let's start the attack. Good luck.
I hope you understand the futility of all of this. You claim the crystals for the Empire. They build their armada. We will find a way to detect it, to destroy it. And then, the Empire will build something bigger and better, on and on and on, until we destroy each other or the galaxy.
Might not be a bad idea if you both destroyed each other. More for the rest of us.
The Empire and the Republic are the galaxy. You'll be caught up in it too. You already are.
Failing to understand that will be your downfall.
I suppose you think that if you just kill me, this will all be over. What did I tell you about destroying great men? The Empire will fail because it insists on being a set of individuals rather than a true citizenship. Because it insists on pushing everyone else to the margins. We pull the weak up and become stronger as a result.
Save your breath. You're dead.
I don't care what you have to do, Major. Find Malgus and find that fleet.
Admiral Shai is dead, and the crystal supply is secured.
Darth Malgus betrayed us. He's taken the crystal fleet. The Emperor knows where.
Grand Moff, it's Malgus on the Holonet.
This better be good.
Fellow Sith, citizens of the Empire. Too long, the strength of the Empire has been beholden to the infighting of the Dark Council and the disappearance of an apathetic Emperor. Sith, children of Sith and warriors everywhere, I declare a new Empire. Open to all who long for conquest, freedom from inhibition, and the right to follow their passions.
What does he think he's doing?
The Dark Council is dissolved. Those who would join Darth Serevin in supporting me, cast aside your titles, and let me lead you to victory. Those who will not, prepare to face our stealth armada. The Emperor is gone. His station and power are mine. We will conquer the galaxy while the Emperor sleeps.
Malgus makes some good points.
Are you mad? The last thing the Empire needs is the civil war. If Malgus is able to construct the stealth armada, he'll be unstoppable. I know I've asked too much of you already, but this new Empire can't succeed. I need your help to stop Darth Malgus.
Taking out Darths never gets old.
Then you ought to enjoy yourself. I will convene an emergency war council. Take this time to prepare for battle, then meet me in my bunker. Darth Malgus will not survive this day.
Heading that way now.
We should have murdered the traitor when we had the chance.
Hunter, at last. Now that Malgus the Betrayer is your prey, do you recall any weaknesses we could exploit?
He waited years to spring his trap. Now it's up to us to claw our way out.
I'm afraid you're right, Hunter. I wasted years serving Malgus. He even asked me to join his treason. Of course I refused, but I should have spit in his face.
A true Imperial would have slain the traitor where he stood.
Regardless, the treacherous dog has stolen our Emperor's cloaked space station and fled into open space.
Grand Moff! Darth Malgus' forces are invading the planet. His ships came out of nowhere and troops are flooding out.
Alert the army. Call for reinforcements. That gutless scum won't embarrass the Empire again.
Malgus has divided his strength by invading Ilum. Now's the time to attack.
The traitor had no choice. He needs Ilum's Adigan crystals to supply his stealth armada.
We can turn this in our favor. A command fighter from Malgus's invading fleet should have his station's coordinates on its nav computer.
Finally, the traitor slips up. Steal one of his ships, and you can fly it straight back to Malgus's hidden space station.
I've never piloted a fleet ship before.
You won't have to. It would be my honor to fly you into battle against the Betrayer.
We need the Empire's top pilot for this mission, General.
I was commander of the Emperor's own attack squadron before joining the Guard. I will not fail you.
Then it's settled. General Hesker will help you seize a stealth fighter and fly you to Malgus's station.
I will prepare my ship at once.
Hesker will drop you on the front lines. You must tear through the Betrayer's army to steal a ship from Malgus's fort. This mission is vital to the Empire's future, Hunter. Succeed, and your loyalty will be generously rewarded.
The Empire is a symbol of strength, respect, and purity. Darth Malgus mustn't corrupt that. Give the word, and we'll rain fire on the traitor's invading army.
I want to be absolutely clear on our plan to secure the stealth fighter.
The ships are secured within Fort Barrow, Malgus's shielded base. Your only way in is through the traitor's army. Once we're over the battlefield, I'll drop you in the trenches. After that, I will provide air support. Now, to battle. Malgus the Betrayer will fear the Empire again.
The Empire sent you. I know. I have seen this moment. Welcome.
Ilum is stained with Imperial blood. As we speak, your army falls to the superior strength of Malgus's force. I'm afraid I was forced to swat down your attack squadron. Troublesome brats had the gall to bomb my base. I hope they weren't friends of yours.
Aside from a traitor to the Empire, who are you?
I am Darth Saravan, right hand to Emperor Malgus, emissary and friend to the Force.
She seeks your stealth fighter.
Thank you, my dear. Talsako is a Voss mystic. Soon she will experience a vision of Voss prosperity under Emperor Malgus. Then all Voss will join us.
Your precious mystic won't have any visions if I cut her down.
Raise your hand against a Voss mystic, and their people will turn against your empire, sealing its demise.
I will survive to watch this battle. I will bow to the victor.
In that case, I will fulfill your vision for the glory of the new Empire.
Darth Saravan was a Voss friend. Now he is gone. I wish it had been you.
This is Hesker. Repeat, this is General Hesker. Do you read me?
Inform the Grand Moff that Darth Saravan is dead, and his stealth ship now belongs to the Empire.
Excellent. Imperial forces are busy securing the fort, and we found survivors. Shall I dispose of them?
Spare us, and my people join the Empire.
Prison will teach Malgus's supporters that the true Empire can be merciful, too.
As you wish.
My family joins the Empire.
Grand Moff Regis already plots our next assault. Secure the stealth fighter, and prepare to slay the false Emperor.
We were just speaking of your exploits, Hunter.
The traitor Saravan deserved his death. The Voss made him weak.
Thanks to you, we've secured his stealth fighter, complete with coordinates to Malgus's cloaked station. General Hesker is prepping it for your final assault.
I'm always a professional.
Of that, there is no doubt, but I'm afraid we have little time to celebrate. Moments after Darth Saravan's defeat, we received this message from the Betrayer.
Congratulations, Regis. Your servant has won Ilum, but victory still eludes you. I have harnessed the Foundry's power. Once its droids assemble my stealth armada, I will crush what remains of your empire with one blow.
I can't wait to wipe that smile off the traitor's face.
Good. We can't afford to delay any longer.
The stealth ship you seized is ready. We fitted it with a homing beacon.
Our fleet will track your vessel as General Hesker flies you to the Betrayer station. Once you're safely inside, we will attack. In killing Darth Tormund, you won our respect. Slay an emperor, and we will be forever in your debt.
You're a welcome sight, Hunter. I took the stealth fighter for a test flight, performed a full systems test. We can leave for Malgus's station on your mark.
Take us in nice and easy. But if Malgus is on to us, get ready for a fight.
I will monitor all enemy transmissions. Now steel yourself. Time we destroy a false emperor.
Just in time for the show, Hunter. Such power! With one movement, our flux cannons fire, and an Imperial capital ship is disintegrated. The Sism Collective has crafted this battle station into the galaxy's greatest technological marvel. Not even your entire fleet can take us down.
The station may survive, but you won't.
You wouldn't dare.
Warning! Stop, meatbag. I hoped you wouldn't be such easy prey. The first shot will immobilize you. The second will spill your slippery components onto the floor.
Let's try to keep calm.
Correction. I have analyzed every possible outcome of this confrontation. All end in violence. Weapons activated? Assassination protocol engaged? I have been looking forward to this.
Guards! Reinforcements! Somebody help! Oh. Please, those things I said in HK, it was all a misunderstanding. Just let me live.
Sabotage your stealth armada? And the Empire will ignore your crimes.
That will take hours. Fine. I'll overload the foundry generators. The results to the hangars will be catastrophic. I'll also program our flux cannons to target the stealth armada. Anything to protect our escape pods. And the Imperial fleet, of course.
We meet again, mercenary. Welcome to my throne room. So much history. So many glory days that slipped away from us. The Emperor is dead. Long live the new Emperor.
I respect your perseverance, Malgus, but not your claim to power.
You're not as foolish as you look. The Empire is withering away. Soon it will be obliterated by decadence and antiquated ideals. Yet still you struggle to keep it from healing, don't you see? Our survival demands a new Empire. Tempered by alien alliances and strengthened by tolerance.
The galaxy's full of independent contractors looking for a side, but your revolution's just encouraging their disrespect.
You are perceptive, but still you have much to learn. My stealth armada will destroy your fleet, and I will destroy you.
Warning. Critical explosions detected on the foundry level. Generators manually overloaded by user ID Arcus Woad.
Enough.
Emergency warning. Power core overrides engaged. Self-destruct initiated.
That was a little extreme, don't you think?
The loss of this battle station is insignificant if it sees the Empire's change. The blast will wipe out your fleet, and only I can deactivate the destruction cycle. die or defeat me. Either way, the Empire is reborn.
Join us, Hunter. Celebrations are in order.
Enjoy this. The imps don't grovel often.
Malgus the Betrayer is dead. You have destroyed the false Emperor.
We just have to settle up, and we're done.
We will not leave your services unrewarded, good Hunter.
Be generous, Grand Moff. It is more than deserved.
General Hesker, your service to the Empire is flawless, as always. What news from the battlefield?
Our fleet suffered casualties, but the survivors escaped the station's blast. The reclamation service already scours the wreckage.
Excellent. Contrary to Malgus's claims, the Empire is stronger than ever. Meanwhile, a traitor's flock is abandoning the flaming ruins of his heretical revolution.
If you want to avoid another rift, you may want to consider some of Malgus's ideas.
The Dark Council has noted the traitor's creed. We shall discuss them elsewhere.
We were in a grave place. Intelligence disbanded, much of the Dark Council slain, and the children of the Emperor defeated. But a new age is upon us.
Already our strength rallies after the fall of Darth Malgus.
The Empire will rise again, and we will always remember the Hunter who secured our victory.